I fell into raising equity for our syndications in an asset class where you probably a lot of your listeners are not going to think that there was some yield at. But again, I was able to see the diamond in the rough and say, that property is in a great area. I have some background in this. I think if I find the right operational partners, this can be a really a home run. And it's actually in bed and breakfast hotels. So we acquired two bed and breakfast hotels, and we're working on our third one right now out in Wichita, Kansas. So basically, I was kind of surfing the web one day, and I came across this property, and I was like, man, that's a really – I know exactly where that's at. That's a really good property. I kind of jumped on the website, saw that it was an operating bed and breakfast. I called the broker up, and I said, look – and he's a residential guy. And so I said, look, I would love to understand the numbers a little bit better on this. Signed the NDA. I got on the phone with a consultant for – a bed and breakfast operating company. And she walked me through all these different numbers. And, you know, I have some hotel background with my undergrad being hotel and restaurant management. And I was able to make some calls to some people and say, is this in line to what you were thinking? And after I evaluated the numbers and the financials for the last 36 months, I looked at the area. I looked at almost just single family home comps just in that area that were similar type. And the purchase price alone was basically enough just to cover the real estate, not the business in that, because they're having a really hard time finding a buyer for a bed and breakfast hotel, which I can understand. But the real estate itself, if somebody was just to kind of move into that property, would have been worth what we were able to get it under contract for, which is great. But the business on top of that added, oh my gosh, probably 50-65% of net operating income that you would not see on a regular property. So we syndicated both of those just from a regular 506 B and C, you know, syndication. So we did we hired a securities attorney, and I was able to transfer a lot of people that I had made connections with on the single family and small multifamily and multifamily side into saying, look, guys, I've got a number of spots here. It's a little bit of a niche product, but here are the numbers, and the numbers didn't lie. And so the last piece I had to figure out were the operations. And so our brokerage firm was actually focused on moving into the hospitality space. We had just hired a COO that came over from Marriott. He had a long stint at Marriott, felt really good about operating hotels. So it was just kind of this whirlwind of perfect kind of timing and you know, me bringing the investors and the different components to it and bringing it to somebody's attention that I felt, you know, because I didn't have the balance sheet to be able to go support a purchase price of that by myself. So I had to have partners that had one, more experience, and two, had a better balance sheet that could help support some of that.